Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thank you for coming back. It's always good to see a familiar face. We're going to talk about fermented and non-fermented dairy products and whether they have an impact on your gut health. I often get, you know, comments from people on YouTube, and sometimes I get comments from people saying that fermented dairy products are actually bad for your health. They're a cow product that people shouldn't be eating, you know, dairy products at all. They're no good. And it's incredible how people get brainwashed by the media, you know. I just read a statistic now that up to 50% of Americans now believe at least in one major conspiracy theory. I mean, so many people want to believe stuff that's not true, all right? So a study was conducted in April this year in France that involved 539 women, right? Now, these are actually documented studies. So this is science, people. This is not some type of conspiracy theory or some hearsay or some kind of stuff they're trying to fudge people off with, right? Fermented dairy products actually really do work, and they help to restore the gut. So what they did is they got a group of about 540 women, and they split the group up like they often do. One group got a non-fermented dairy product, which was basically the control, and the other group received 125 grams, which is what I think about 5 or 6 ounces or something of a fermented dairy product, which contained probiotic strains. So they received that twice per day for between 2 to 4 week period. And what they found is the women who had the fermented versus the non-fermented noticed a significant improvement in the comfort of their digestive system. We're talking mild symptoms like bloating or gas or things like that. So switching to a yogurt, for example, a properly made yogurt, a good organic one, can have a significant effect, an impact, positive impact on your gut. Hey, be sure to get my free Candida shopping list, guys. I mean, I put this together years ago for patients. Click on the link in the description box below if you want it. It's a pretty cool thing to have in your pantry or hanging on the fridge or take with you shopping, because it's going to show you stuff that's going to be really help you, including different types of fermented, you know, foods like the yogurt, which I'm a big believer in. So there you have it. It's good to eat a little bit of fermented foods regularly here and there. Now you're saying, well, hang on, Eric, I can't eat that crap. I get bloating and gas and things when I eat things like kefir or yogurt. So you may have to get your gut into a little bit better shape before you can really tolerate the yogurt. So make sure you look at my other videos. I do talk about fermented and cultured foods quite a bit. Thanks for tuning in.